إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهديه وسار على سنته إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله تعالى وطاعته ولزوم أوامره وكثرة مخافته، فإنها شعار المؤمنين ودثار المتقين، ووصية الله في وفيكم أجمعين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. إخوتي في الله، الحياة في كتاب الله عز وجل ومشتقاتها 145 آية تتحدث عن الحياة، حياة الخلق ومشتقاتها، يحيي وأحيينا حياتنا إلى آخره من هذه المشتقات. والموت كذلك، الموت ومشتقاته في كتاب الله عز وجل 145 آية. وهذه الحياة والموت التي ذكرت في كتاب الله عز وجل تأتي لمن يتمعن في بيان القرآن في معنيين: المعنى المتعارف عليه وهو الحياة العضوية والموت العضوي، إنسان يتنفس، إنسان يأكل ويشرب، وكذلك الحيوانات تأكل وتشرب وتمشي وتقضي حاجتها وتقضي رغائبها وغرائزها. هذه الحياة اللي مذكورة في كتاب الله عز وجل. قال ربي إبراهيم عليه السلام: أرني كيف تحيي الموتى، قال: أولم تؤمن، قال: بلى ولكن ليطمئن قلبي، قال: فخذ 4 من الطير فصرهن إليك، ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا، ثم ادعهن يأتينك سعيا. حياة. والموت كذلك إخواني الأحبة، ما في إنسان ولا نفس إلا وستذوق ذلك الموت العضوي المؤقت، الذي لو أعفي منه أحد لأعفي منه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، ومع ذلك يقول الله عز وجل له: إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون وإنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون. هذا هو المعنى العضوي إخواني الأحبة. لكن لمن يتأمل في كتاب الله عز وجل ويدقق، يجد أن الحياة والموت قد جاءت بمعنى كذلك آخر، لمن يحب، لمن كان له قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد، ألا وهي حياة القلوب، حياة المبادئ، حياة الهدف في هذه الحياة، حياة المواقف. الحياة موقف إخواني الأحبة، كما ذكر في كتاب الله عز وجل. فكم من أناس تحت الأرض وهم بالناس أحياء، وكم من أناس يسيرون فوق الأرض وهم في حقيقتهم أموات، كما قال الشاعر: قد مات قوم وما ماتت فضائلهم، وعاش قوم وهم في الناس أموات. يقول الله عز وجل في وصف تلك الحياة إخواني الأحبة بذلك المعنى الثاني الجميل لمن يتعمق به، يقول الله عز وجل: ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. إذن هذه هي الحياة التي يتحدث الله عز وجل عنها. وفي المقابل هناك كما قلت أناس يسيرون على فوق هذه الأرض ولكنهم أموات، يقول الله عز وجل فيهم: لهم قلوب لا يفقهون بها، ولهم أعين لا يبصرون بها، ولهم آذان لا يسمعون بها، أولئك كالأنعام بل هم أضل. ما تفرقهم بينهم وبين من هو تحت الأرض. والأمثلة كذلك كثيرة في كتاب الله عز وجل تعمق هذا المعنى، معنى الحياة، حياة المواقف وحياة المبادئ وحياة الاتباع للحق والوقوف أمامه والاستسلام إليه. إخواني الأحبة، يقول الله عز وجل: إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين. إذن كتاب الله عز وجل هو إنذار لمن كان قلبه حي، أما أولئك الذين يسيرون فوق الأرض بقلوب ميتة فهؤلاء الذين قال الله عز وجل: ويحق القول على الكافرين. ويقول الله عز وجل وهو يقارن في مقارنات جميلة: وما يستوي الأعمى والبصير، ولا الظلمات ولا النور، ولا الظل ولا الحرور، وما يستوي الأحياء ولا الأموات، إن الله يسمع من يشاء وما أنت بمسمع من في القبور. وما أنت بمسمع من في القبور، لا يستوي الأموات والأحياء إخوان الأحبة. ورسول الله عليه وسلم مهما دعا ومهما تحدث ومهما أراد أن يدل، من كان يقف أمامه وهو من أهل القبور كيف يستمع وكيف يهتدي وكيف يتحرك وكيف يسير في ذلك الطريق؟ ويقول الله عز وجل: أو من كان ميتا فأحييناه وجعلنا له نورا يمشي به في الناس كمن مثله في الظلمات، مثله في الظلمات ليس بخارج منها. فرق كبير إخواني الأحبة. فمن فقه الحياة والموت بهذا المعنى، حياة القلوب وحياة المواقف وحياة الهدف وحياة الاتباع للحق، هؤلاء إخواني الأحبة عندها ينظروا ويعلموا ويفقهوا أن الموت ما هو إلا بوابة. هذا كل الموت اللي يخاف منه الناس واللي يحزن عليه لفراق الأحبة وغيره وغيره، ما هو إلا بوابة. تفتح البوابة ثم تنتقل إلى الحياة الحقيقية، الحياة التي هي الأبدية، الحياة الجميلة التي فيها النظر إلى الله عز وجل، حياة التي فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر، حياة فيها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وصحبته الشريفة، كما قال أحد الصالحين حينما سئل: أخبرنا عن الجنة، شوقنا عن الجنة، فقال: يكفي أن فيها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه، فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله كما أمر، والصلاة والسلام على خير البشر محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه الميامين الغرر. ما اتصلت عين بنظر وأذن بخبر وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Dear brothers and sisters, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his servant and his messenger. Peace be upon him and upon all the messengers of Allah from the time of Adam through Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and the seal of the prophets, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon all of them. Dear brothers and sisters, when you read the Quran and you count the verses that the word of life, haya, and all derived words from the haya, yuhi, the one who give life, life, the one who, our life, any of derivation of the word life, they will find that it is 145 times mentioned in the Quran about the life and the living of the humans and any creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the same time, when you count the word death, al-maut, And everything that is derived from the word al-maut, mata, yamutu, mautatana, all of these words, also they will find it. It is 145 times mentioned in the Holy Quran. But if you go one step further and you read the Quran and reflect on the verses of the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, deeply and with reflection, you will find that life and death were mentioned in the Quran in two different meanings. The first meaning is the one that we are all used to, biological life and death. As Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, show me how you can resurrect or bring things to life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to take birds and to cut them and to mix them and to put each mix on top of a mountain and then call them and they will come to you resurrected, flying, live. So this is the life, that biological life that we all know about. When you see someone walking, breathing, eating, drinking, fulfilling their desires, nothing different than any animal or any creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing is for the death. Many verses in the Quran refer to the death of that moment when life ceased. And everyone is going to taste from that cup of death. As it is mentioned, even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, innaka mayyitun wa innahum mayyitun, you are gonna die and everyone else is going to taste that cup. But the other meaning, dear brothers and sisters, is that beautiful meaning of life and death as it is mentioned in the Holy Quran. And that is the life of the hearts, the life of principles, the life of stands. Where do you stand? The life of purpose, that you are existed for and the purpose of your existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to all those meanings using the term haya. In the same time, in the same thing, the contrary, those who lack those stands and those principles and those with dead hearts, Allah referred to them as dead. In so beautiful demonstration of those meanings, dear brothers and sisters. The greatest verse that we all remember, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ, don't think, don't imagine or even think for a second that those who died for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are really dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَلْ هُمْ أَحْيَا, they are living with the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ, well provided with the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't think they are dead just because you don't see them breathing anymore, just because they are now under the ground. They are alive. They're stand on this earth for what is right, for what is for the truth, and they sacrifice their life for it. They strive for, they sacrifice their life for what they strive for as the truth. That's made them living creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, eternal life. On the same way, and on the other hand, dear brother and sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to those dead. Even though they are walking on this earth, they have eyes, they have ears, they have a heart that pump blood and so on. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does He refer to them, describe them? لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. They have hearts, but they don't understand with it. وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنْ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا. They have eyes, but they don't see with it. وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. And they have ears, but they don't hear with it. And they don't listen with it. أولئك كالأنعام بل هم أضل. They are like cattle, or even worse and more stray than cattle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another verse said, إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. Allah is referring to this, remember, this words, this holy Quran, this revelation as a Quran مبين. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لينذر من كان حيا. So you can give a warning and a reminder for those who are truly alive, for those who have a living heart, who is willing to understand and to listen and to comprehend and to submit. And Allah referred to those who don't do that, وَيَحِقُّ الْقَوْلُ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. Those who deny the truth will be against them in the day of judgment. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave also in the Quran many beautiful comparisons. Like the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءُ وَلَا الْأَمْوَاتِ. Allah says, وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرِ. That it's not equal, the blind with the sighted. وَلَا الظُّلُمَاتُ وَلَا النُّورُ. And darkness and light are not equal, Allah says. وَلَا الظِّلُّ وَلَا الْحَرُورُ. And also being under the shade compared with being under the heat of the sun is not the same, is not equal. And then Allah finished the verse by saying, وَلَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَمْوَاتُ وَلَا الْأَحْيَاءُ وَمَا يَسْتَوِي الْأَحْيَاءُ وَلَا الْأَمْوَاتُ. And also, those who are living are not equal to those who are dead. Allah is not referring to those who are under the ground, dear brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to those who are having living hearts compared with those who have eyes but they don't see, they have ears but they don't hear, they have hearts but they don't understand. They are nothing different than those who are under the ground. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُسْمِعُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah has the power to make anyone He wills hear and listen. وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُسْمِعٍ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ. But you, O Prophet of Allah, you cannot make those who are in their graves dead hear you. And Allah is referring to those who are standing in front of the Prophet ﷺ. They see the truth, but they live a life without any purpose. And they have nothing to live for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another verse says, أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. Is it conceivable that those who were dead and then we gave them life, and they, we gave them and blessed them with the light that they will walk with it, which is the truth, which is the Holy Quran, the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they walk with it among the people with that light. Is it conceivable that those are equal to those, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. Like those who live in darkness, لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا, and they never gonna get coming out of it. How did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refer to those who are in darkness and those who are having the truth? Allah says, فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ, we gave them life. They are living human beings, and they have a living stand and understanding of life. If we understand, dear brothers and sisters, life like this, that it is the life of the heart, it's the life of what you establish and the athar, the things that, and the signs that you leave behind. The heart of stand for the truth and strive for what is right. The life that will make others remember you even 50, 60 years after your death. They will always think of you as a living example and model in front of them. Those who have life like this, dear brothers and sisters, they will realize that death, the one that is we are all afraid from, that moment of death that make us so upset and so sad and grieving when we lose and miss someone whom we beloved. If we understand life as like this, dear sisters, then we realize that death is nothing but a gate. That the one who is really leaving us, he is nothing but opening that gate and entering to a new, beautiful, permanent, eternal life. A life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describe that it has فِيهَا مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. It has things that eyes never have seen before. وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ. Things that ears never heard about. وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. And things that did not even come as a notion passed by the heart of a human being. When we talk about life as a principles and standing for the truth and being there when you are needed and when Islam is calling for you to be there, those who they will understand that death is nothing but that gate that separates them from that beautiful meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One time, some of the people asked one of the righteous, tell us about paradise, things that will make us love Jannah. He said, there is a Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in the Jannah. That by itself is something that will make your heart looking to meet him in that Jannah. So if you understand life like this, dear brothers and sisters, that it is not breathing and eating and sleeping and fulfilling your desires, but on the contrary, it is the life of the heart, the life of principles, the living principles and stand in your life, that will then, it will change your understanding of what is life is about. You find many people around you, and when you meet with them, even if they are sometimes 70, 80, 75 years old, but you see life is so vital and so like beautiful in their way of looking at life, in the way they stand, in the way they provide for others, in the way they help, in the way they understand their purpose in life. And when they depart from this life, yes, you feel bad about it, that they are not around you anymore. We have so many of those beautiful faces that we still remember. But you know what? When we are sitting together and we talk about one of them, we talk about them as if they are around us and among us. This is a reality, dear brothers and sisters. It's not a fantasy. They have this walking like a TV show that It's called The Walking Dead. I did not watch any of it, but maybe few minutes, in, even though they say it is, has been going and running for so many years now. But it shows the people who are like zombies, walking with bleeding face, broken limbs, and they call them like walking dead. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to those who don't live for a purpose, who have a dead heart, are exactly like those walking dead that they are talking about. But on the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that you live for the truth, you stand for the truth. Allah is telling you, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ. That's a big difference, dear brothers and sisters. Life is what you define it to be. And the life of the prophets, peace be upon them, was all life of stands and mawaqif, what we call it. All their life is standing here and there for what they believe in, and they were ready to sacrifice their life for it. The life of the Prophet ﷺ was a mawqif. When he stood up in front of his uncle, in front of all the temptations and the threats and so on, and then he said to his uncle, Ya ammah, لو وضعوا الشمس في يميني والقمر في يساري على أن أترك هذا الدين ما تركته إلا أن ينصره الله أو أهلك دونه. If they put the sun in my right hand, we always say that. We always sing this beautiful song about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who is living in the heart of the people, billions and billions from the time of the revelation until the day of judgment. He is a living model in the heart of the people. If you put the sun in my hand and the moon in the other hand, so I will give up on my deen, I will not, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it victory, or I will perish defending and striving to fulfill it. That was, is a true life, living example of what his life is about. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, when he comes to the masjid and the Sahaba are all broken hearts, they are collapsing on the ground, they don't know what to do, they are all confused. And he walked all the way to the member and stand up and he says, من كان يعبد محمدا فإن محمدا قد مات ومن كان يعبد الله فإن الله حي يموت. Whoever lived, used to worship Muhammad, Muhammad is dead, peace be upon him. But whoever worship Allah, Allah is eternal, never die. وما محمد إلا رسول قد خلت من قبله الرسل. One stand by Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه in that position is, will define his stand in the whole life of the companions and in the life of the people. We now 1500 years later, we are still telling that stand as if we see it with our own eyes. When Umar radiallahu anhu comes a Christian who's been beaten and been oppressed by the son of the prince Amr ibn al-As in Egypt. And he traveled all the way to Umar, and Umar radiallahu anhu asked the prince and his son to come all the way to Medina. And then he stand up in front of Umar and in front of his son, give the whip to the hand of the Christian and tell him, and whip his father, because without the influence of his father, he wouldn't dare to do it. And then he said that statement, يا عمر متى استعبدتم الناس وقد ولدتهم أمهاتهم أحرارا. Since when you treat people like slaves, when their mothers gave them their life as a free people. Now, 15, 1600 years, that is one of the main principles in the chart of the United Nations. That is what is what we say life, true living, as mentioned in the Quran. The living stand for the truth and for what is right. Ali radiallahu anh, when he was asked to sleep in the bed of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that is a moment that is written in the history and in the life and in the hearts of the believers all over. When he was ready to sleep in the bed of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he knows that they are ready there, so many men of that all tribes are about to crush inside and to kill him and assassinate him, thinking that he is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the stand that define what is a living person is, a role model is. When Uthman radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle of Tabuk, and at that time in Ramadan, so hot and there is not enough resources, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stand up encouraging the companions to donate for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide for the army. So he said, who will provide for this army? Who will sponsor this army, this battle? And he is rewarded with Al-Jannah. Stand up Uthman radiallahu anhu. Ya Rasulallah, O Prophet of Allah, 100 camels completely equipped on me. And then he sat down. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's face, as usual, completely enlightened with light and happiness. Then he asked again, who is going to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa lahul jannah? Uthman stand up again. Another 100 camel for the sake of Allah, O Prophet of Allah. Completely equipped. In the third time, and he immediately says, another 100 camel. And here is the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا ضَرَّ عُثْمَان مَا صَنَعَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. Nothing is going to harm Uthman after today. Life is a stand in that moment, dear brothers and sisters. You stand for the truth. And we have our own Uthmans. Our community has our own Uthmans. In our first fundraising dinner, when we were imagining and thinking that we, as a whole community, we will collect about 70,000, and the Sheikh was calling upon the people, Sheikh Abdullah Idris, who will donate, who will donate, a hadith and ayat. And then we have an Uthman from this community who stood up and said 100,000 for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another Uthman stood up and said another 100,000, another 50,000, and we end up with 750,000 in the first fundraising dinner. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are others who will come behind the scene and say, when we were not able to collect any more donation in that day, and he will say, whatever the people, all of those who are present will collect, I will match. That is by itself, dear brothers and sisters, are those kind of stands that we are talking about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is teaching us, whoever left any hardship from a Muslim in this dunya, Allah will lift him one of the hardships of the hereafter. Whoever make that kind of a stand, dear brothers and sisters. وَمَنْ نَصَرَ مُسْلِمًا فِي مَوْضِعٍ وَذَبَّ عَنْ أَخِيهِ أَوْ عَنْ عِرْضِهِ فِي مَوْضِعٍ ذب الله عز وجل عنه وعن عرضه في موضع يحبه أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Whoever stand up to defend a Muslim and protect him and defend his honor in a situation or a status or a position where that oppressed will be so happy that have someone or some brother who will stand up for them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will have him have equally rewarded in a position or in a moment when he is in desperate need for it and he is in love for it. اللهم اجعلنا الذين يستمعون القول فاتبعون احسنه هذا واعلموا ان الله قد امركم بامر بدا بنفسه وثنى بملائكته قدسه فقال جل من قال ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما اعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت اللهم تدعنا في مقامنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا همّا إلا فرجته ولا كربا إلا نفسته ولا عسيرا إلا يسرته ولا محتاجا إلا كفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا مظلوما إلا أيدته ولا ظالما جبارا إلا قصمته ولا مجاهدا في سبيلك إلا نصرته اللهم انصر اخوان المجاهدين في كل مكان اللهم ثبت الأرض من تحت أقدامهم يا قوي يا عزيز اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحومة وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصومة ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقينا المحرومة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله على ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة